Howdy folks, I gathered from my YouTube analytics that 78% of total viewers have not subscribed. Kindly subscribe if these videos are of any help, or even if it's not that important, please be kind and generous enough to subscribe so I could feed my cat. Let's begin. In my recent videos, I have discussed a bit about fully pressurized LPG ships. Where comparing us to a fully refrigerated LPG ships, including LPG road tankers, were tackled. So in this segment, I will familiarize you first with the cargo control room and associated equipment for this fully pressurized LPG ship, then later on proceed with related cargo operations. So for those who are waiting for oil and chemical tankers topic, it's in the pipeline and will be dealt with pretty soon. Please comment below if you think my lectures or presentations are worth watching and you're benefiting at all. I would appreciate comments, suggestions, or honest-to-goodness reactions. There are always rooms for improvements. Otherwise, these discussions will not serve their purposes effectively. So, let it all out and let me know. Please comment. Let's familiarize you with this fully pressurized LPG ship. We are here at the bridge, or what we commonly call as the navigating bridge room, where a while ago you have seen all the gizmos running from the previous video inset. Hence, we are going down to the CCR or cargo control room area. So, as of now, we are exiting from the bridge deck through the accommodation main stairway. And let's just pass it forward till we get to the upper deck. The upper deck is mostly where you will find the ship's common office, if any, and the CCR, along with the galley and mess rooms for officers and crew, respectively. So, as we are looking at right now, we are walking through the upper deck alleyway, proceeding to the cargo control room. So, from here, I'll be familiarizing you with all the equipments or other related consoles and whatever you can see inside the CCR. What we are looking at right now are our computers, and of course, there are many of them. In fact, in different ships, you'll find more computers. And this is a bilge alarm, which is the inset picture, as you can see right now. Again, this is a gas detecting panel. I'll explain that a little while. And the other panel, the bigger one on the right, is basically the system that monitors the pressure, temperatures, and levels of the cargo tanks for 1 and 2. Of course, you have also local gauges and local monitors that you can find on the main deck. So it's a redundancy of equipment wherein you can do your operations while you are in the cargo control room. Likewise, you can also manage the operation while you are outside or in the main deck, just on top of the pipings and deck area. So you can see here also and observe that there are a lot of gizmos that are seen. As you can see right now, this is a portable gas measuring equipment, and it can measure a lot of things. Multi-gas detectors like H2S, carbon dioxide, and oxygen. And depending on the ship that you are into, but actually whatever is that the ship is designed to, and expected gases that can be found or detected, then that's the kind of equipment that you'll have according to regulations. And as you can see also and notice that the it clutters a lot of cabinets and papers posted on the walls. So this is for easy information and data access. And again, this is another multi-purpose detecting equipment for gas measuring, like hydrocarbon gas in by volume, and the so-called LEL or lowered explosive limits. And again, I've mentioned a while ago that you'll see a lot of documents and papers posted on the walls. And this is because you cannot memorize everything, but at least you know where to find them. So this is actually an equipment or like a laptop for computations of cargo quantities and the stability dynamics of the vessel during cargo operations, whether it's planning or ongoing operations like loading and discharging, the ballasting or ballasting, and any other related cargo operations. So everything is done in these computers. And there are also computers that is online, which is actually presently actively monitoring the system on deck or on the tanks. It can give you all the readings outside. So it's a redundancy of equipment that you'll find on board ship, especially on gas tankers. So you can control from the inside and also from the outside, so locally and remotely. So again, this is a gas detecting funnel. It's a PIX system. It's not portable. So the sensors are PIX, and this is a processing unit. So it tells you where are the areas that is taking samples, and it gives you the reading. This is another panel I have shown you earlier, wherein the tank's pressure, gauge, level, pressure, temperatures. So, and even flow if it has a system of measuring of flow of liquids, etc., and so on and so forth. Number one item is the high level or high level sensor. This can be utilized to test also for the high alarm level and high level by unscrewing the wire. But in actuality, when there is overflow of liquid or the intended liquid level is reached and still it didn't stop, then this will activate the ESD because it has reached the high level sensor. The number two item is a spindle. This can be used as well to push the hydraulic in case the ESD has activated. So it's like a reset system. The number three item is the cargo sampling valve. There are about two in this zone, the top and the bottom. It can be used for taking samples and also used for draining the line when doing purging. Number four item is the liquid top spray valve. If you have a high pressure during loading, then this could be utilized for diverting also the flow into the top spray, and hence by showering the cargo vapor, it would lessen the cargo tank pressure because the vapor will cool down, and hence when it cools down, of course, the latent heat of vaporization will subside as well. So some of the vapors will turn into liquid and tank pressure will go down. And if still, of course, the pressure is high, then of course the compressor can be used, so the vapor can be extracted from the tank dome top or vapor bulb, and it goes to the compressor and suck in, and then of course this compressor gas will be injected into the liquid line. So the liquid line, while loading, the liquid is passing through in that system. So basically it's the liquid that is actually utilized to condense the compressed gas, and hence it becomes liquid. So the tank pressure will also go down. Number five item is a cargo tank pressure release valve. It cools down the tank as well when you release pressure. Number six item is a hydraulic line valve, and close to it is a fusible plug. It's color red, so if there's a fire or explosion, it releases the pressure in the system for the hydraulics, and then the ESD, which is basically a fail-safe system, it releases and activates the ESD, so everything will go. The fusible plug actually is activated under regulations at 98 degrees to 104 degrees Celsius. And the following images again is console, where outside or on top of the deck, wherein you could see the pressure of the cargo tanks and vapor temperature. Temperature sensors for the liquid in different level, top, middle, and bottom. And so here are the three main types of fully or even semi-pressurized gas carrier containment. In this first image, I have included the LNG spherical type B. It's actually the 1G type, where full measures of preventive measures of safety is designed for this vessel. However, the remaining images is for the fully pressurized containment vessel, wherein in this build design, required by regulations, this is the model that has been used in this topic. So as you can see, there are three tanks here, although the one that I'm showing you right now in the videos and in some images are two tanks and actually just aligned to each other within the hold. So it's inside, there's no tank on top. And likewise, the other one, which is the same, except that there is no tank on top. These are the types of containment.